I am Ashish Jawalkar, working as assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are learning about robot programming and its different methods. Let's look into it. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be acquainted with robot programming and understand the different programming methods associated with today's robot. So let us start. Robot today can do much more than merely move its arm through a series of points in space. Current technology, robots can accept input from sensors and other devices. They can send signals to pieces of equipment operating with them in the cell. They can make decisions. They can communicate with computers to receive instructions and to report production data and problems. All of these capabilities required programming. There are various methods used for programming robots. The two basic categories of greatest commercial importance today are lead-through programming and textual language programming. So let us know what is lead-through programming. Lead-through programming consists of forcing the robot arm to move through the required motion sequence and recording the motions into the controller memory. Whereas textual programming methods use an English-like language to establish the logic and sequence of work cycle. Now, in addition to the lead-through and textual language programming, the another method or another form of programming for low technology limited sequence robots. These robots are programmed by setting limit switches, mechanical stops, and other similar means to establish the endpoints of travel for each of the joints. This is sometimes called mechanical programming. The work cycles of these kinds of robots generally consist of a limited number of simple motions, for example, pick and place applications, in which these manual programming is adequate. Now let us move to lead-through programming methods. Now in this, the lead-through method requires the programmer to move the manipulator through the desired motion path, and that the path be committed to memory by the robot controller. The lead-through methods are sometimes referred to as teach-by-showing methods. Chronologically, the lead-through methods represent the first real robot programming method used in industry was in the early 1960s when robots were first being used for industrial applications. Lead-through methods are used to program playback robots. In the case of point-to-point playback robots, the usual procedure is to use a control box called a teach pendant to drive the robot joints to each of the desired points in the workspace and record the points into memory for subsequent playback. The teach pendant is equipped with a series of switches and dial to control the robot's movements during the teach procedure. Continuous path playback robots also use lead-through programming. For well-defined paths, such as moving along a straight line between two points, a teach pendant can be employed to teach the locations of two points, and the robot controller then computes the trajectory to be followed in order to move along the straight line path. There are two ways of accomplishing lead-through programming. Those are powered lead-through and manual lead-through. We'll come towards powered lead-through method. The powered lead-through method makes use of a teach pendant to control the various joint motors and to power drive the robot arm and wrist through a series of points in space. Each point is recorded into memory for subsequent playback during the work cycle. The teach pendant is usually a small handheld control box with combination of toggle switches, dials, and buttons to regulate the robot's physical movements and programming capabilities. About the various robot programming methods, the powered lead through method is probably the most common today. Now, yeah, it is largely limited to point-to-point motions rather than continuous movement because of the difficulty in using the teach pendant to regulate complex geometric motions in space. A large number of industrial robots applications consist of point-to-point movements of the manipulator. These include part transfer tasks, machine loading and unloading, and spot welding. Now we'll go through manual lead through method. The manual lead through method, also sometimes called the walkthrough method, is more readily used for continuous path programming, where the motion cycle involves smooth complex curvilinear movements of the robot arm. The most common example of this kind of robot application is spray painting, in which the robot wrist with the spray painting gun attached as the end effector must execute a smooth regular motion pattern in order to apply the paint evenly over the entire surface to be coated. Continuous arc welding is another example in which continuous part programming is required, and this is sometimes accomplished with the manual lead through method. In manual lead through method, the programmer physically grabs the robot arm and manually move it through the desired motion cycle. Here, the teach pendant or the teach button is often located near the wrist of the robot, which is depressed during those movements of manipulator that will become part of the programmed cycle. This allows the programmer the ability to make extraneous moves of the arm without their being included in the final program. The control system for both lead through procedures operate in either two modes, teach mode or run mode. The teach mode is usually to program the robot, and run mode is used to execute the program. The two lead through methods are relatively simple procedures that have been developed and enhanced over the last 20 years to teach robots to perform simple repetitive operations in factory environment. The skill requirements of programmers are relatively modest, and these procedures can be readily applied in the plant. Now we'll come to textual programming method. So, textual programming methods use an English-like language to establish the logic and sequence of work cycle. A computer terminal is used to input the program instructions into the controller, but a teach pendant is also used to define the locations of the various points in the workspace. The robot programming languages names the points as symbols in the program, and these symbols are subsequently defined by showing the robot their locations. In addition to identifying points in the workspace, the robot languages permit the use of calculations, more detailed logic flow, and subroutines in the programs, and greater use of sensors and communications. Accordingly, the use of textual language corresponds largely to the so-called intelligent robots. Some examples of kinds of programming statements that would be found in textual robot languages include the following sequence: speed 35 APS, move P1, close 40 mm, wait 1 second, depart 60 mm. The series of commands tells the robot that its velocity at the wrist should be 35 inch per second in the motions which follow. The move statement indicates that the robot is to move its gripper to the point P1 and close to an opening of 40 mm. It is directed to wait and second before the departing from P1 with a distance of 60 mm above the point. Future enhancement of textual language programming will be to enter the program completely offline without the need for a teach pendant to define point locations in the program. The potential advantage of this method is that the programming can be accomplished without taking the robot out of production. All of the current methods of programming require the participation of the robot in the order to perform the programming function. With offline programming, the entire program can be entered into a computer for later downloading to the robot. Offline programming would hasn't change over from one robot work cycle to the new work cycle without a major time delay for reprogramming. Unfortunately, there are certain technical problems associated with offline programming. These problems are mainly concerned with defining the spatial location of the position to be used in the work cycle. And that is why the teach pendant is required in today's textual robot languages. These are the references for the lecture presented. Thank you.